question we have learned regarding the line clipping algorithm called Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm. Here the clipping process means we should consider only the portion which lies within the window boundary, and we should ignore the portion which lies outside the window boundary. The first and foremost thing we need to know is, first we have to define the window. So by defining a window, we need to consider this window boundaries W, XW minimum and XW maximum, XW, YW minimum and YW maximum. And the Cohen-Sutherland the line clipping algorithm performs based upon the region codes. So we need to perform all the regions for the neighboring windows, and then we will apply the clipping for given lines that we have seen in the previous session. And in now, let us have a discussion on one more line clipping algorithm called Liang-Barsky line clipping algorithm. Liang-Barsky line clipping algorithm. So whereas Cohen-Sutherland algorithm works based upon the region codes and end operation, and here in the Liang-Barsky line clipping algorithm, just we will give a time interval for the starting point and ending point. So based upon the time interval, we will calculate the intersection point. So if we consider two points, some x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2. So there is a line from x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2. Let it be the time interval at initial point it is 0, and time interval at final point is 1. So the line, that means starting x1 will travel to the x2 at a time interval 0 to 1. So here, what about the intermediate point? That means finding the intersection point. So we need to find the intersection point on the boundary itself. So here, let it be an intersection point here at a particular time interval t. So we doesn't know the t. So it will be in between 0 and 1. The t lies between 0 and 1. At initial position t is 0 and final position t is 1. So at an intersection point, let us consider the time interval as t. So we need to find the x comma y coordinate at this particular time interval. For that, let us derive a formula. X is equal to, so how much distance the x2 has been traveled, so t into x2 plus how much distance the x1 has been traveled, 1 minus t into x1. How much distance x2 has been traveled, t, that is this part, and how much distance x1 has to be traveled, this part. So from here x is equal to t into x2 plus x1 minus x1 into t. So x1 plus t into x2 minus x1. So this we call it as delta x. X1 plus t into delta x. So this is the formula to find the x coordinate at a particular time interval t, where t lies between 0 and 1. Where t lies between 0 and 1. So this we can call it as a parametric line equation. So directly we can write a formula, parametric line equation, as x is equal to x1 plus t into delta x. Similarly, y also. So y is equal to same formula, we should derive the y coordinate using the same formula. So I am writing directly the formula, y is equal to y1 plus t into delta y, where t lies between 0 and 1. So these are the x and y coordinates at intermediate position, in between starting position and ending position. So here in our Liang-Barsky line clipping algorithm, this point, the intermediate point itself, is the intersection point on the window boundary. Right? Now, As you know, the window is defined based upon the window boundaries, that is xw minimum and yw minimum, xw maximum and yw maximum. So the boundary window boundaries are xw minimum, yw minimum and xw maximum and yw maximum. Now, so these are the two different coordinates at a particular time t, where t lies between 0 and 1. Now, so we know that according to the point clipping algorithm, if we consider any point x, y, so definitely the x and y coordinates must be in between the x and y window boundaries. So then only we consider the point itself lies inside the window. That means the conditions of where we have seen in the point clipping. Let us consider some x, y. If x, y, to check whether this point lies inside the window or outside the window, just we have calculated the conditions. So those conditions are xw minimum less than or equal to x less than or equal to xw maximum. So x should be in between x window minimum boundary and xw window maximum boundary. Similarly, yw minimum less than or equal to y less than or equal to yw maximum. So this we have seen these two conditions in point clipping. So these are the four conditions. We have seen these are the four conditions. Now we know the x and y values, that means at a particular intersection point. Just write down those x and y coordinates formulas in these two equations so that we can get xw minimum less than or equal to x1 plus t into delta x less than or equal to xw maximum. Similarly, yw minimum less than or equal to y1 plus t into delta y less than or equal to yw maximum. So just we are substituting x and y formulas which we have derived earlier. So those we are substituting in x and y coordinates in these two equations. So we get the four conditions. See, these are the four conditions we got. So now let us divide these two expressions into four conditions. So here there are four conditions. So this is one condition, this is another condition, and this is one condition, and this is another condition. So let us divide these conditions, four different conditions. X1 plus t into delta x greater than or equal to xw minimum. Similarly, x1 plus t into delta x less than or equal to xw maximum. Similarly, y1 plus t into delta y greater than or equal to yw minimum. And y1 plus t into delta y less than or equal to yw maximum. So just we have written the four different conditions. So individually we have written the four conditions. Now, so there is an inequalities, because in two conditions there is a greater than symbol and in two conditions there is a less than symbol. Now let us derive a common expression for these four inequalities. It should be like t into pk less than or equal to qk. So we need to derive this general expression for these four inequalities. So for that purpose, just write down, convert this into t into delta x greater than or equal to xw minimum minus x1. And this would be similar, t into delta x less than or equal to xw maximum minus x1. Similarly, this also t into delta y greater than or equal to yw minimum minus y1. Similarly, this one t into delta y less than or equal to yw maximum minus y1. And here also there is two different expressions, two different operators. That is, for two expressions we are having less than symbol, and two expressions we are having the greater than symbol. So in order to get this one, just multiply. See, this is first, second inequality, third one, and fourth one. So for this purpose, we need to derive this common expression t into pk less than or equal to qk. So we need to change this greater than and this greater than into less than. That means equation 1 and 3 should be multiplied with minus 1, so that the greater than symbol will be getting into less than symbol. See, now the first expression will be minus t into delta x less than or equal to x1 minus xw minimum. Similarly, t into delta x less than or equal to xw maximum minus x1, because this equation 2 doesn't change because it's already in less than symbol. That is also a general expression. Now equation 3, here it is greater than, so multiply with a minus 1. Minus t into delta y less than or equal to y1 minus yw minimum. Similarly, t into delta y less than or equal to yw maximum minus y1. So these are the four equations or four conditions. So based upon these conditions only, we need to find whether the given line is inside or outside the clipping window. Now, so these four are in a general expression t into pk less than or equal to qk, where k is from 1, 2, 3 and 4. So four conditions. So k is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let us write individually what is a p1, what is a p2, what is a p3, what is a p4. So here p1 is equal to minus t here minus delta x, and p2 is equal to delta x, p3 is equal to minus delta y, p4 is equal to delta y. Similarly, q1 is equal to x1 minus xw minimum, q2 is equal to xw maximum minus x1, q3 is equal to y1 minus yw minimum, q4 is equal to yw maximum minus y1. So these are the four conditions we need to be derived. So based upon these conditions, based upon these values p1, p2, p3, p4, and q1, q2, q3, q4, so based upon these eight values we need to find whether the given line is inside or outside. So which portion lies inside and which portion lies outside. See, now let us have a look. First of all, if pk is equal to 0, if the pk, any one pk value is equal to 0, that implies line is parallel to window. Right? Note down carefully. If pk value is equal to 0, so any p value is 0, that implies the line is parallel to window. The line may be inside, the line may be outside, or line may be within the boundary. So here, if the corresponding k value, qk value, so here PK is equal to 0, if PK is equal to 0, the line is parallel to window. So if PK is equal to 0, then if QK is less than 0, if PK is equal to 0 and QK is less than 0, that implies the line is outside. And if QK is greater than 0, the line is inside or partially inside. The line is partially inside. So if QK is equal to 0 within the boundary. So this also partial, maybe partial. That means if this is the creeping window, the line will be like this, parallel, inside, parallel. So some portion is inside and some portion is outside. Here also, if this is a creeping window, the line may be within the boundary. Within the boundary. Here also, the completely within the boundary itself, or some portion lies within the boundary and some portion outside the boundary. And this is for PK is equal to 0. The first condition, PK is equal to 0. If the PK value, any corresponding PK value is 0, the line is parallel to window. If the line is parallel to, if PK is equal to 0, we need to find the corresponding Q value. So if QK is less than 0, the line is outside the window. So the line is outside means the line may be here, here, or here, or here. But it will be parallel. And if QK is greater than 0, the line is inside or partially inside. The completely inside or partially inside. QK is equal to 0 within the boundary, the completely within the boundary or partially within the boundary. Now, if PK is less than 0, if PK is less than 0, so we need to find an x comma y value at a particular time interval t1. So first we need to find the t1. T1 is equal to, we need to consider a maximum of 0 comma qk by pk. So we need to find the time interval, at what time, at particular time interval the point is intersection point. So note carefully, this is an intersection point, that means within the boundary itself. So at this t1 we need to find the values of x and y. So we know the formula, at a particular time interval we need to find the x and y. The formula is x is equal to x1 plus t into delta x, y is equal to y1 plus t1 into delta y. So this is the formula to find x y at a particular time interval t1. If pk is greater than 0, if pk is greater than 0, that implies we need to find the time interval t2. So t2 is equal to maximum, here maximum, so it is minimum of 1 comma qk by pk. 1 comma qk by pk. So corresponding qk values and pk values we need to find. And at a particular time interval t2, we will get the time interval t2. So at a particular time interval t2, we can find the coordinates x is equal to x1 plus t2 into delta x, y is equal to y1 plus t2 into delta y. So this is the formula to find the x and y coordinates at a particular time intervals t1 and t2. Here t1 and t2 are nothing but the intersection points on the boundary. And if t1 changes, T1 changes, let it be, T1 is the initial point and T2 is the final point. So as we know that P1 and P2, X1 comma Y1, X2 comma Y2, and here T1 is equal to 0, T2 is equal to 1. As we know that we have said that time interval at the initial point is 0 and time interval at the end point is 1. Here we have defined that the initial time interval is denoted as T1 and the final time interval is denoted as T2. So here if T1 is equal to 0, that indicates there is no change in the initial point. That means initial point is inside the window. because t1 is equal to 0. If t1 changes, that means if t1 not equal to 0, that implies the initial point is outside the window. The initial point is outside the window. So where at what point the boundary starts, that is t1 value. There itself we need to find the x and y coordinates. So at this particular x and y coordinates, the point starts within the window. And similarly here, if t2 changes, so if t2 is equal to 1, automatically the second end point is inside the window. And if t2 not equal to 1, that implies the point is outside the window. The point is outside the window. So for that purpose, at a particular time t2, we need to find the intersection point, that is x, y. So based upon these values, these complete values, we can find whether the given line is inside, which portion of the line lies inside and which portion of the line lies outside. So a simple formula, just we are using a point clipping expressions, the conditions, and we have derived four individual conditions, and just we have derived in a general format t into pk less than or equal to qk, and where q, where k is 1, 2, 3 and 4, because we have derived four conditions. So from that conditions, we have derived p1 value, p2, p3, p4, q, similarly q1, q2, q3 and q4. So based upon these 8 values only, we can find whether the line is inside and what portion of the line is inside and what portion of the line is outside. So if the two points, consider the two points p1 and p2, x1, y1 is p1 and x2, y2 is p2. And at initial point, we are denoting the time interval as t1, that is equal to 0. And at the end point, we are denoting the time interval as t2, which is equal to 1. So if two, here, if the calculations, if the pk value, any one of the pk value is equal to 0, then that implies the line is outside, the line is parallel to the window. So here the line is parallel, I am saying that line is parallel. So the line may be outside, inside or within the boundary. That depends upon the qk value, corresponding qk value. If qk value is less than 0, where pk is equal to 0 and qk is equal to less than 0, that implies the line is outside the window. And if qk is greater than 0, that implies the line is outside, inside. The complete line may be inside or the partial line may be inside. And if qk is equal to 0, the line may be on the within the boundary itself. And if non-zero of pk values, pk less than 0, the time we need to find the time interval t1, that means starting position. So at the starting position of a line, that means t1 is equal to maximum of 0, comma qk by pk. If here, if t1 changes, that means initially t1 is equal to 0. If t1 is not is equal to 0, after calculations, that implies the initial point is outside the window. So that we need to find a point at a particular time interval t1. So in the beginning itself, we have derived a formula for x and y at a particular time interval t1, that is equal to x is equal to x1 plus t into delta x, y is equal to y1 plus t into delta y. So this implies x, y is the point where the line started in the window. Similarly, if pk is greater than 0, the t2 must be calculated, that is end point. Initially the end point is 1. If we get the answer as other than 1, that implies the end point is outside the window. So for that purpose, we need to find the intersection point at a particular time t2. So for that, we are using the same formula. So remember, simply remember, the formula is same, the only difference is the changing of t1 and t2. Right? So if t1 changes, that implies the starting position is outside the window. If t2 changes, that implies the end position, end point is outside the window. If both changes, t1 and t2 changes, that implies that both the initial point and end point are outside the window. That means, see, if let us consider a window like this, if t1 changes, the line goes from outside to inside. So it is t1 and it is p2. We need to find the x and y at particular t1 right? So similarly, if T2 here, let us say window. So here it means the line goes from inside to outside. So P1 and P2. So we need to find the intersection point T2. So here we are finding x comma y. If both T1 and T2 changes, that implies if we consider a window like this, the point, the line goes from outside to outside through the window. So we need to find the T1, we need to find the T2. Here we have to find the xy, here you have to find the xy. Simple. The same formula we have to use, but the only difference is at time interval, T1 and T2. Have an example solving this Liang-Barsky line clipping algorithm. So in this, as we have said in the previous session, that we have to calculate the 8 values, P1, P2, P3, P4 and Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 values, and based upon those values we need to find whether the portion of a line is inside and what portion of the line is outside, and we need to find the intermediate intersection point on the boundary. So let us have a look for this. So let us consider a window boundary as xw minimum is equal to 5 and xw maximum is equal to 9. Similarly, yw minimum is equal to 5 and yw minimum is equal to 9. And let us have a line with a point P1 4,12 and a P2 8,8. So that means the line, we are considering a line from 4,12 to 8,8. Now let us have a look. So this is the window. So yw minimum, this is xw minimum, xw maximum, and this is yw minimum and yw maximum. This is 5 and this is also 5 and this is 9 and this is also a 9. Now the line starts from 4,12. Let us plot a graph so that we can easily understand from this. Now the window boundary xw minimum is 5,25 and maximum is 9. Yw minimum is also 5 and maximum is 9. Right? So this is the window. Now plot the line 4,12. 4,12. So 4,12 means here, and 8,8. So 8,8. So this is the line. So this is 8,8. This is 4,12. So this is a T1 and this is T2. We need to clip this line. So for this purpose, just we need to know the weight values, P1 values and P2, Q1 values, QK values, PK values and QK values. So here the window boundaries has here given. Here is xw minimum is equal to 5, yw minimum is equal to 5, xw maximum is equal to 9 and yw maximum is equal to 9. Yw maximum. Right? Now let us have a look. P1 is equal to minus delta x, P2 is equal to delta x, P3 is equal to minus delta y, P4 is equal to delta y. Similarly, Q1 is equal to X1 minus XW minimum, Q2 is equal to XW maximum minus X1, Q3 is equal to Y1 minus YW minimum, Q4 is equal to YW maximum minus Y1. So we need to find all these values. So we know that X1 and Y1, see, here the X1 comma Y1 is equal to 4 comma 12, X2 comma Y2 is equal to 8 comma 8. Let us solve here. Now, first of all, let us find the delta X. Delta X is equal to X2 minus X1, that is X2, 8 minus 4, that is equal to 4, and delta Y is equal to Y2 minus Y1, 8 minus 12, that is equal to minus 4. So we can have these values. P1 is equal to minus delta X, so P1 is equal to minus 4. P2 is equal to delta X, P2 is equal to plus 4, minus delta Y, here already is minus 4, minus of minus 4, P4 is equal to delta Y, that is minus 4. Now let us find the Q1 values. Q1 is equal to X1 minus XW minimum. Here X1 is 4 minus XW minimum, 5, 4 minus 5, that is minus 1. Q2 is equal to XW maximum, that means 9, minus X1, 4, that is 5. 9 minus 4, that is 5. Next, Q3 is equal to Y1 minus YW minimum. Y1 is 12, YW minimum is 5. 12 minus 5, that means 7. Next, Q4 is equal to YW maximum minus Y1. YW maximum is 9. Y1 means 12. 9 minus 12, minus 3. So we have found this delta X, delta Y, P1, P2, P3, P4, and Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. So here, none of the above is 0 value. That means a non-zero of P. So let us have PK less than 0. PK less than 0. So how many values are less than 0? P1 and P4. So we need to calculate for P1 and P4. Right? So here at the P1, the PK less than 0, we need to find the time interval T1. So T1 is equal to, the formula is maximum of 0 comma Qk by Pk. So Qk by Pk is here two qualities, that means the two values are less than 0, P1 and P4. So we need to write Q1 by P1 comma Q4 by P4. Similarly, what are the values which are greater than 0? Greater than 0 is P2 and P3. So P2 and P3. Now, so at Pk greater than 0, time interval is T2. So we need to find the T2. T2 is equal to minimum of 1 comma Qk by Pk. So here the values are 2 and 3. So we need to write minimum of 1 comma Q2 by P2 comma Q3 by P3. See, here maximum of 0 comma Q1 by P1. Q1 is minus 1, P1 is minus 4. That is 1 by 4 comma Q4 by P4. Q4 is minus 3, minus 4. That is minus 3 by minus 4. That is 3 by 4. Similarly, P2 is equal to minimum of 1 comma Q2 by P2, 5 by 4, comma Q3 by P3, 7 by 4. See, we need to calculate, so for time interval T1, we need to find out the maximum among these three values. For finding the time interval T2, we have to find the minimum of these three values. Now find out the maximum of these three values, that is here 0, this is 0.2 and this is around 0.7. So this is the greater. So T1 is equal to 3 by 4. T1 is equal to 3 by 4. Here T2 is equal to 1 comma, so 1.2 and 1.8. So the minimum value is 1. So what value have been changed? T1 has been changed because initial value of T1 is 0 and initial value of T2 is 1. So T2 doesn't change. That means the end point is within the window boundary. And T1 has been changed. So it implies the starting position, that means the starting point is outside the window boundary. So if you observe the graph, the starting point is outside the boundary and the ending point is inside the boundary. So the T2 doesn't change, but T1 changes. So we need to find the intermediate point here. This is the intermediate point. So at particular time interval 3 by 4, so at 3 by 4 we need to find the x and y coordinates. So for that we know that x and y coordinates, x is equal to x1 plus t1 into delta x. That means x1 here, x1 is 4 plus t1, 3 by 4 into delta x, 4. So it is 4 plus 3, 7. The x value is 7. And similarly, y value. Y is equal to y1 plus t1 into delta y. So y1 value is 12 plus t1 value is 3 by 4. Delta y is minus 4. So 12 minus 3, that is 9. So x is 7 and y is 9 at particular time interval 3 by 4. T2 doesn't change, so we need not find out the x and y values at T2. So the T1, the values at time interval 3 by 4 is x comma y, that is equal to 7 comma 9. So here we can see this is the point 7 comma 9. This is under 7 and this is under 9. So it is correct. So we have clipped the line in between 4, 12 and 7, 9, and the line which is inside the window is 7, 9 comma 8 and 8. So here in this example, as we said, the initial value T1 has been changed. That means T1 is not equal to 0 because initially the T1 value is 0 and initially T2 value is 1. So here the T1 value changed. That means the starting position is outside the window. T2 has not been changed. That means the end position is inside the window. So at the starting position, at this particular time interval, we need to find the x and y. That implies that is the intersection point on the window boundary. So based upon these 8 values, we are finding the intersection point. So if this T2 also changes, we need to find the xy coordinates at that particular time interval. That means if the line passes from, if the line is like this, we need to find the T1 and we need to find the T2. So here in the given line 4, 12 to 8, 8, we have clipped the line from 4,12 to 7,9, and we are just considering the line from 7,9 to 8,8. So this implies this line lies inside the boundary and this line lies outside the boundary. So clipping has been done, and the clipping has been done in between the points 4,12 to 7,9. So hope you understood this simple Liang-Barsky line clipping algorithm. And let us stop here, and in the next session let us have a discussion on polygon clipping algorithms. And thank you.